Space Dragon and Kim.
I'm making the world's spiciest meatball, and I'm gonna get Kim to eat it. It's the world's spiciest meatball. It'll make her sweatier than an armpit.
Oh, I'm so hungry. I could eat a giraffe.
Hungry, you say? Well, luckily, I've been experimenting with recipes all day. First, I made a toothpaste and orange juice float. Then, I made this BLT sandwich. The B stands for boogers. The L stands for lard. And the T is for the grossest topping of all, tomato.
Hey, I like tomatoes.
Agree to disagree. All right. But for my main course, yep. I made these super delicious, super spicy meatballs.
Oh, yeah!
The sauce contains one of the hottest peppers in the world.
Oh, no!
The Carolina Reaper pepper.
Okay, now normally I would never recommend eating something made with a Carolina Reaper pepper. But I'm so hungry. And this does give us a good opportunity to explore the science of spicy food.
The science of spicy food.
She's gonna do it.
I'm a scared space dragon. I'm a scared. Here we go. Okay.
OMG. Jeez, I cannot believe you just ate that.
That's one spicy meatball.
Ladies and gentlemen, she just ate a meatball sauce made out of the Carolina Reaper pepper, one of the hottest peppers on the planet!
Oh, it's so spicy.
I'm so sorry.
Oh my gosh, why would you do this to me?
You're a scientist. You like to experience new things, right?
Okay. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's so bad. Oh. Cap Season! Why must you be so cruel?
I'm sorry. Cap Watson?
Capsaicin is the stuff that's inside peppers. It makes it feel like your mouth is on fire.
Capsaicin! That's the word of the day!
That's so weird.
That was weird.
So capsaicin is actually also found inside pepper spray, which is what like policemen use to like fight off robbers. And you know what? It's actually produced naturally inside the pepper to defend itself against evil fungus. See, plants usually want us to eat their fruits so we will spread their seeds throughout the globe when we poop them out.
Gross.
But pepper seeds actually get destroyed in the stomachs of mammals like humans, you know, like me. So the plant is all like, yo, I don't want humans to eat me because their stomachs destroy my seeds, so I'm gonna make myself taste nasty to them with capsaicin.
Okay, and I heard a rumor that birds' stomachs don't actually destroy the seeds.
That is so true! That is so true! Birds actually feel no pain when they eat capsaicin. So peppers actually evolved alongside birds so that the birds would gobble them up, like fly away, and like poop out the seeds all over, allowing these plants to grow and spread.
I can't believe you just said poop on the internet. Like, is that even allowed? Can someone check that? Are you allowed to say poop on the actual internet?
No!
Okay, so what you're saying is that peppers do want birds to eat them, but not humans. So they evolved to be spicy for humans, but not birds, okay? Right, but like, how can something taste so hot when it hasn't even been heated up by a microwave or a stove? Like, they feel cool to touch.
Okay, good question. So the capsaicin stuff actually activates these things on your tongue, here, called nociceptors.
Yeah.
Called nociceptors.
Okay? Nociceptors.
And these things trick your brain into thinking that your tongue is on fire, signaling danger!
Okay, Kim, you are sweating a lot. Why are you sweating so much?
Okay, well, that's easy. You see, my brain is being tricked into thinking that I'm on fire, so it's making me sweat to help cool me down.
Wow. Okay, I mean, who knew that making meatballs would end up teaching me so much about spicy food and bird poop? Kim, I'm so happy that I could eat a giraffe.